So dear children, in last video we talked about three rights, and today we will talk about that fourth right, that is right to freedom of religion. That is, we have already learnt in earlier chapter that you children must be knowing about India is a secular country. Okay, so what you mean by secular? It is same over here, that is a right to freedom of religion, that any citizen of India can follow the right of, can follow the religion of his or her wish. Government doesn't have any religion, government doesn't interfere into any religion matters, government doesn't favor any particular religion, and the citizens of the nations are free to follow the right of their wish. Okay, it is right to freedom of religion. Any citizen of India can follow any religion of choice, can promote and propagate the same in mentioned into the provision of the Constitution of India. Okay, but this right is to enjoy it with some permissible limits so that it doesn't affect the freedom of the public administration, okay, morality and health of the society. The religious gathering, offering or prayers are not included in this. Okay, the state of India doesn't have any religion, as I said. Okay, its own or the Indian state is not run as per the principles of any religion or any sect. The state cannot interfere into the religious matter, as I said, into the religious belief. Okay, the religious group have been given a freedom to establish any religious organization and can manage and administrate by their own. The state cannot use the fund collected through the public taxes or the public fund for the benefit and development of any particular religion. Education institution running on the government grant cannot impart any religious education or compel the students to follow any particular religion. Okay, right. Fifth, cultural and educational right. So when we talk about this cultural and educational right, people of the various religion, language, culture live in India. It is multilingual, multi-language, multi-food, multi-style, multi-dressing. So it can be said that India is like a subcontinent. The people of India have a right to preserve their language, scripts, culture, identity and ethnicity. Any educational institutions which rely on the government grant cannot deny admission on the ground of the religion, caste, creed, language or any other reason. If any individual appears to vote on the ground of the religion, caste or the language, then it is considered a malpractice as per the article of 123 sub article 3. Any of the states can frame a law and provide right to the citizens to form, the manage and to educate the institution, educational institution based on the cultural or linguistic minority. The state shall not discriminate in giving educational grants or educational scholarship from the state's fund to any of the linguistics or the religious minority institution. If the state desires to take over or confiscate, to confiscate matlab to take away the property of the minority, okay, institution, then it can be do so only after giving the proper returns. Okay, like that you cannot take, you should go legally. In this way, important provisions in context of education institutions, okay, have made in the Constitution of India. So there is a provision for the same. Right to constitutional remedy is called to be the soul of all the rights, my dear children. Okay, no matter how many laws are framed or how many provisions are made for the fundamental rights, if these are not implemented well, then the remain of no meaning of such freedom. Therefore, a provision had been made in the Constitution for the implementation of these rights, and under it, a writ in the Supreme Court can be made. Okay, a writ can be done on the Supreme Court. for the violation of the fundamental rights. So you can go to the Supreme Court if it is found that your rights are not exercised. These rights has been accepted as the right of the constitutional remedies. Remedies called to be solution. The Supreme Court plays an important role in protecting the fundamental rights, and for this, if the court finds it necessary, that it can give orders, instructions or decrees. The apex court, that is Supreme Court, vested with the power given by the Constitution. Nobody can oppose it, so everybody has to accept. If any person puts a complaint against any state for the violation of any fundamental rights, then the Supreme Court can exercise the right. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, who is in the foundation of our Constitution of India, who has framed the Constitution of India, is considered right to constitution remedies as the soul of the Constitution. Okay? The Parliament can hand over the power of giving such an order to any of the court. If the State Legislative Assembly frame any law which violates the fundamental rights or not in a congregance of its, then the Supreme Court can stop the state. Thus, this rights provides an opportunity to any of the citizens to approach the court with the violation of the right. The Constitution provides the fundamental rights to the citizens. These rights are given against the government, either it is the central or the state. The fundamental rights are applicable to all its citizens every time, but can be suspended during the time of emergency. Okay? Either it is a national emergency, either it is the outer emergency. No states can form any law which take away the fundamental rights of the citizens. So, my dear children, these are the three remaining rights that we have discussed. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss about the fundamental duties and the directive principles of the state policy. As a part of your homework, you will mention all these six rights and you will write at least 5 to 6 lines for each rights and compress it, and that you will put in your fair and you will show it when it is asked. Okay, we continue. Take care. Bye-bye.